Hello, YouTube. Welcome back. This is Nikki Pratt, Jesus Wants You, the Watchman on the Wall. And she's still praying. We're still praying. We're going to pray for Houston. This song came to mind, and I want to play it before I pray, if you guys don't mind. It's so fitting, and I want to dedicate this song to all my family and all the people in the Houston area, the state of Texas, that's dealing with this catastrophic event. You know, sometimes he chastens the ones he loves. And sometimes he has to do certain things to us to get our attention. I know he did me. And sometimes we can avoid that if we don't run from him or if we just obey and just open up our hearts. But anyway, I won't talk long. I want to dedicate this song. It's called Total Praise. It's 4 minutes and 44 seconds long. 444, go figure. So I'm gonna let you hear it. Of course, YouTube got a home with these. So special commercial.
Thank you, guys. in a time of need. He allows you to live through that hurricane. He's a great and mighty God.
Man, that was back in the day. That's an old song, but back in the day, that was one of my favorite songs. One of my favorite songs, and I would tear up in the choir stand every time I sung it, every time. And it's just, it's anointed. I'm going to tell you, oh, I didn't mean to do that. It really is. It's a very special song. But how many of you know that Houston, Texas area, all those that's been afflicted by this storm needs prayers? I'm still praying. I know a lot of you still praying. We need to pray. We really need to pray. And you guys need to continue to pray. I'm sorry if I look a little idle. I'm trying to pull up. I would like for you guys to touch and agree with me once again to pray on behalf of Houston. A lot of them, they have no idea how blessed they were. You know, a storm hitting at a Cat 4. Katrina didn't even hit at a Cat 4. But yet the impact of this storm, I mean, the brunt. They still were spared the brunt of the blow. Corpus Christi, Baytown a little bit? No, not Baytown. There's another city, but I know Baytown, Dickinson, some of the hardest hit, but all of Houston. It's pretty much the hardest hit. And we wanna lift them up. We wanna lift them up in prayer because it's praying time. It's not playing time. And it's time to get real with Christ. I don't know where you are. You may be listening and you're from the Houston area. We just wanna pray for you today. We wanna pray that throughout all this, you praise Him. In the midst of the storm, you give Him glory, even in the midst of your trials and your tribulation. Because He said in His word that you will have trials and tribulations. Amen. Let's bow for prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank You for this day that You have given us. Lord, we will be glad and rejoice in it. Father, we ask, Lord God, for forgiveness of our sins, known and unknown, forgiveness of sins of omission and commission, and all the seven deadly sins. Father, we purify our hearts before You, O Lord. We purify ourselves unto You, Lord God. Father, I lift up all the people, Lord God, of Houston, all the surrounding cities, all those, Lord God, that is affected by the storms in their families. Father, I even lift up all their family members that are concerned of each and every one of their families that has been affected by this storm in some kind of way. Whether by flood, whether just by damage to the house, or Lord God, we lift them up to You right now. Father, I pray, Lord God, that You give these people, Lord, the peace that surpasses all understanding, not as the world gives, O Lord, but as You give. Father, I pray, Lord God, and bind every spirit of Pharaoh, Lord God, that is coming against the people, Lord God. Lord, that they can't even see you in the midst of calamity. Lord, I pray, Lord God, that their hearts will be open, ready, primed, ready to receive you this day, Lord. Lord, I pray, Lord God, that you lift them up, Lord, even in their spirit, Lord, even those that feel like they have lost everything, but Lord, they have no idea. They only lost everything, Lord God, if they don't have you. And Father, I pray, Lord God, that you speak to their hearts today, Lord God, and let them know that without you, they can't have anything. Without you, they have nothing. Lord, your word says that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but you deliver them out of them all. Father, I pray, Lord God, as a result of this calamity, this tragedy, Lord God, there were loved ones, Lord God, that have lost people. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that and bind every spirit of anger, every spirit of hatred, every spirit of bitterness that would come, Lord God, as a result of the moves of their family members. Father, I pray, Lord God, that they would have a forgiving heart towards others that feels like that they have left them or resisted or rejected them in some type of way. Father, we bind those spirits in the name of Jesus. Father, we bind every hindering and distracting spirit that will come against them, Lord God, from even allowing them to see you in the midst of tragedy, in the midst of calamity. Father, I pray, Lord, that they would seek your face. I pray, Lord God, that they would be brought to their knees. They would recognize and know that you are God. Father, there is no other Lord. There is no other God but you. Father, let them know you today. Father, I pray, Lord God, and lift up all those that may be still stuck in houses. Lord, I pray, Lord God, in their darkness while the light's out, Lord God, let your light so shine. Let your light shine, Lord God. Let there be another boat. Let there be a helicopter. Let there be someone, Lord God, pass back by their house. Lord, let there be a door open where they can be found. Lord, if there's anyone, Lord God, that needs breathing room, that is trapped by a wall, that is, Lord God, that is collapsing, Lord God, I pray that, Lord, that wall will be uncovered, that they would have breathing room, that they will be able to get untrapped. They will be found this day, Lord God, showing your glory so they would know who you are. I pray, Lord God, that while they are in the midst, Lord God, of a trial, in the midst, Lord God, of somewhere where they feel like they have lost everything. Father, I pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that they would know who you are at this moment. Father, I pray and lift up all the elderly to you. I pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, that all those that are in the midst of confusion, Father, I loose, Lord God, your peace and understanding on them. Father, let there be people, Lord God, put it up on their hearts to go by and check on the elderly to make sure that they are right on, Lord. Father, I pray that they will be clothed in their right mind in the name of Jesus. For a mind that is stayed on you, Lord God, is a mind in perfect peace. Father, I lift up to you, Lord God, those that are in tears and that are crying out, Lord God. Father, I pray, Lord God, that they cry out to you. And Father, when they cry out to you, I pray that you show up in their life, oh Lord. Show up, Lord God. Great is thy mercy. Great is thy faithfulness. Father, in the name of Jesus, you said, whosoever shall call upon your name shall be saved. Father, let them be saved. Father, I lift up all the pregnant women to you, oh Lord. All those that may be pregnant, Lord God. Lord, we bind every premature labor. Father, we place the blood of Jesus over those, Lord God, that will be sick and in any type of anguish or turmoil, any type of anxiety, we bind it in the name of Jesus. Lord God, loose your healing, your ministering angels, Lord God, around about them. Lord, loose your ministering angels, Lord God, around those to let them know, Lord God, that it will be okay. Lord, let them know, Lord God, that there is joy in the morning in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray, Lord God, that you speak to that one, Lord, that feel like they are lost. Father, let them find you. Lord, let them keep their focus on you. Let them not lose sight. the name of Jesus. Father, those that may be stuck somewhere, and Lord, there is no one in sight. Father, I pray, Lord God, for a ram and a push in the name of Jesus. Father, provide a ram for them to be able to be rescued in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray and lift up those that are being helicopters, rescued by helicopters and boats. Father, I pray for their protection. The blood of Jesus goes with them in and coming out. Lord, I lift up to you all the nurses, all the EMTs, the fire department. Lord God, all the first responders, all the military, all those, Lord God, the policemen, all those that will be riding their vehicles, Lord, in Jesus' name. Father, I pray, Lord God, that no one will get trapped or stuck. Father, any trap or snare set against anyone, Lord God, he will escape like a bird in the name of Jesus. Father, the sun shall not smite them by day, nor the moon by night. In Jesus' name. Father, I pray for that child. I pray for the family, Lord God, that are in fear. Father, we bind every spirit of fear, for you have not given them the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. Father, we bind in the name of Jesus all price gouging, Lord God, with hotels and gas pumps. At the gas pumps, Lord, we bind it in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray, Lord God, that you loose upon those people, Lord God, that would do such a thing. Father, I pray, Lord God, that you loose your love, your spirit within them. Lord God, to be able to provide, to be able to be fair, to be truthful in the name of Jesus. Father, we bind every spirit that would try to come against these people and oppress them in their time of need. We bind it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, go before those that can't find their way and make their crooked path straight. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, let them that need to hear your voice. Lord God, hear you tonight. Those that may be getting ready to be trapped in the building, Lord God, in apartments, in hotels, in their houses, Lord God, when you speak to them to tell them leave, Father, I pray, Lord God, that they would leave. They would hear your voice this day. Father, right now, Lord, I ask, Lord God, that you go before them, make their crooked path straight, part every Red Sea, and tear down every Jericho wall. Father, I pray that they will hear you today. In Jesus' name, I pray that they will hear you today. Father, we know that there is much more flooding to go on, Lord. Father, I lift up all the news anchormen, the weathermen, all those that are risking their lives. Lord God, all the good Samaritans. Father, I pray, Lord God, for their protection. I plead the blood of Jesus up over them. No weapon formed against them shall prosper. Lord God, let not the foot of pride come against them, neither let the hand of the wicked remove them. Father, I pray, Lord God, that all those that are in charge, delegating in the operations, Lord God, attending to those in need, Lord, let not pride come against them. Father, I pray, Lord God, that they would meet every need. Father, your word says, never has the righteous been forsaken or his seed begging bread. Father, feed those that will be hungry. Clothe those that need clothes. And give those water, Lord God, that is thirsty. Father, they that seek you, Lord, will never thirst again. Father, I pray for all those that are in the apartments, all of our family members. I lift them up to you, O Lord. Father, I pray, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, there's a lot of them, Lord God, that sought to live another day. So, Father, there is a work that you would have them to do. Father, your word says that you would deliver them when they're in trouble. You would satisfy them with long life. Father, I pray, Lord God, as a result of this calamity, Lord God, you will show up in their life. Lord, they shall live and not die. They shall live to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living. Father, they are living today. Father, there is work to be done in the kingdom. And I pray, Lord, that there will be more added to the kingdom as a result of this. In the name of Jesus, all those, Lord God, with pride in their hearts, Lord, we bind it and rebuke it. All those, Lord God, that have given over to idols, Lord, we bind it and rebuke it. Father, I pray, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that you give them a heart of conviction. Father, let them look at their hearts, Lord God, and address themselves accordingly. Father, I lift them all up to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And I pray, Lord God, for their heavenly priesthood, that they be found without spot, without blemish, without blame. Father, I ask, Lord, in all the high-rise areas, Lord God, that you open up reservoirs for all water to go into. Areas, Lord God, where the water will back up in the name of Jesus and overflow in the neighborhood. Father, I pray, Lord God, that you park those waters, Lord God, and make dry land. Let that extra water, Lord God, go in reservoirs away from their neighborhoods, away from people, oh Lord. Father, I pray, Lord God, that they find refuge in you. I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that they found safety in you. Father, I pray that you speak to them, Lord, even in their dream state. Those that don't know you, those, Lord God, that don't believe in you. I pray, Lord God, that tonight you will show up, Lord God, in a divine intervention. Let your ministering angels speak to them, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus, speak to them, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let there be divine appointments. Let your all those, Lord God, that are righteous, that are there, Lord God, to give you glory. Father, I pray that, Lord God, and lift them up to you, that they light so shine that will draw all those unto you because of the light in them. Father, all those that have darkness in them, Lord, I pray that the light will come against them to obliterate all their darkness. Father, I pray and loose peace, tranquility, and unity upon the people. Lord God, let them continue, Lord God, to help each other, to pull together in spirit on one accord, Lord. Lord, we loose your love, your peace, your joy, your happiness in this city. Lord, we bind every spirit, Lord God, of anyone. We cancel, we devour, we dismantle, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Anyone that would answer to Satan and his minion, Lord God, to carry our plans of robbery, to carry our plans of rape, we bind it and rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Father, protect the people, Lord God, as they travel on the road. Father, I pray that you give them wisdom and understanding when they go out in the nighttime, Lord. Father, give them the unction in their spirit to say, no, 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 stop. In Jesus' name, don't go into that water. Lord, I pray that you give them an unction in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that there will be some, Lord God, that will give their lives over to you, those that don't know you. Father, those that believe in Hinduism, Buddhism, Rastafarian, worshiping idols, other gods. Lord, I pray that this calamity, Lord God, will bring them to you. In Jesus' name, Lord, take care of the children. Lord, give them peace. Lord, they're in their pure innocence. Lord God, let them be a help for their parents. In Jesus' name. Lord, we love you. We know that you're going to answer our prayers because you touch and agree and there is power in numbers. Father, you said in your word that the prayers of the righteous availeth much. And you're rewarded to those that diligently seek you. Lord, I want to thank you, Holy Spirit. Lord, I want to lift up to you, Lord God, all those that are praying, all those that are growing weary, that may be growing weary as a result of praying. Lord God, we bind the hand of the enemy, Lord God, with scattered thoughts. Father, I pray that you will bring back all scriptures to their remembrance. Father, we bind prayerlessness. We bind forgetfulness in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray that you will loose up on your people a praying spirit in the name of Jesus. And Father, those that may be fasting, Lord, I pray that you give them strength in your weakness because the joy of the Lord is our strength. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us in the name of Jesus. Father, you said in your word that they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Father, I pray that this day and this day going forward, even in their fast, Lord God, that their strength will be made today. Lord, your strength is made in our weakness. Father, we thank you. We glorify your name. Lord, we thank you for your omnipotence, your love, and your power. Lord, loose your power upon your people today. In Jesus' name. Lord, we fill this prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. All right. I didn't think that was going to be that long, but praise God. Praise God. Continue to pray for the people and lift up the people in the Houston area. A lot of us have family members out there. I know I do. I have a praise report. I finally talked to my first cousin. She is okay, and she's in an apartment in Houston. She decided to stay, and I texted her like last night before I went to bed. I think it was probably like 11 midnight, somewhere along in there, and I didn't hear back from her, so I kind of didn't get any sleep. But besides her, I have other family members that is out there. My husband's family, his brother, my brother-in-law, his sister-in-law, nieces, nephews, cousins, host of cousins that are out there on my side and my husband's side. So we both have family out there. And I know you guys have family out there. And just do know that always in this house, you know, I pray and I lift you guys up in prayer each and every night. There is not a night go by or a day go by that I don't lift you guys up in prayer, and I pray that you do the same for me. But definitely continue to pray for the people, because we know that it ain't over. But he can do exceedingly and above all that we can ask or think. All he needs from the people of Houston, you guys spread the word, is for them to repent. This is an hour of repentance. When Jesus was in the wilderness for 40 days, he came out preaching, for the kingdom of God is at hand. And he preached the message of repentance. And the same with Noah, the same with, you know, Lot and the angels. They went in trying to warn the people, trying to turn them, their hearts back to Christ. Back to God at that time, and they didn't want to do it. And that's how it is today. I need you people of Houston to turn back to the Lord. If you don't know him, check this video. If you've never accepted him, because let me tell you, you were spared for a reason. And even what looks like a bad thing, a calamity, which it is, I'm not negating it, and I'm not saying it is not. But I'm saying, even in the midst of this trial, smile, because it could have been worse. You could have lost your life. And if you wasn't right with the Lord, you have that time to get right with him now. Look at it that way. Because there's a lot that died and didn't have that chance. It's a lot of people that went before you and didn't have that chance. So you have that chance today. And that's a blessing. You're on the top of the ground. You're not 6 feet under. So you get the chance to do it over. You get a do-over. And that's called mercy. But let me tell you, he said in his word, he is long-suffering, but he will not always strive with man. And I talked to another minister, and she said that the Lord told her that grace and mercy was getting ready to leave the earth. That ain't good. A lot of people survived so we want to keep it that way. We want to keep them prayed up. We want to pray that the people's hearts turn to Christ. I love you guys. See you next video. Thanks.